The Philippines will continue to push for cooperation with China and work towards more partnerships and collaboration. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said that to Chinese Premier Li Qiang during a brief conversation after the ASEAN summit in Jakarta. In that summit, Marcos said the Philippines will continue to assert the rule of law in settling maritime disputes. He also emphasized practical cooperation in the maritime domain can only flourish with an enabling environment of regional peace, security, and stability anchored in international law.
A Philippine finance official is confirmed to have been pushed out of her post, with sources citing various factors. Undersecretary Chelo Magno says she will return to teaching at the University of the Philippines, adding it will give her flexibility to advocate for good policies. At the finance department, Magno oversaw the Fiscal Policy and Monitoring Group, which is responsible for formulating tax reform proposals and other fiscal policy recommendations. Before she announced her resignation, Magno posted a cryptic photo showing the chart of the law of supply and demand. Her post garnered comments saying Magno should teach economics to cabinet members as well as to agriculture and trade officials. Magno's resignation will take effect on September 16.
President Marcos making moves at the ASEAN summit to improve the Philippines' rice supply. The Philippines and Vietnam are finalizing a five-year rice cooperation agreement following a meeting between Marcos and Vietnam's Prime Minister on the sidelines of the regional summit. Hanoi's leader assured Marcos of a steady supply of rice imports from his country. Marcos earlier imposed a rice price cap at home amid a spike in prices and supply issues of the staple grain. Aside from agricultural cooperation, the Vietnamese leader also thanked Manila for expanding its ties with Vietnam in other areas, including maritime security.
Philippine House lawmaker Stella Kimbo says a declaration of a state of national rice emergency will be a comprehensive toolkit for the executive department. The Congresswoman has filed a bill empowering the president to declare an emergency amid supply issues and elevated prices of the staple commodity. She told ANC this will help address the woes of all industry stakeholders.
Right now, it's actually more, it's permissive. So it allows the executive to help consumers, farmers, and actually other suppliers, meaning even traders if necessary. In a situation, for example, right now, as a result of the price ceilings, because of the price ceilings, for example, retailers are unwilling to let go of their stocks, then if the executive needs to give subsidies to them, then at this point in time, then the bill authorizes them to subsidize the retailers.
More private sector support is needed to help provide out-of-school youth with pathways to employment. That's according to the U.S. Agency for International Development, or USAID. The agency has so far helped 36,000 youth across the country find jobs or start their own businesses. It is targeting to help 180,000 youth by 2025. But its partner, the Philippine Business for Education, admitted there's still stigma around hiring out-of-school youth, and they hope to raise awareness among private employers. USAID is also working with several government agencies to provide the youth with proper education. The wholesale price growth of general commodities in the Philippines increased in July despite the high inflationary environment. The growth rate of general wholesale price index at the national level went up to 4.5% in July 2023, higher from June's 4%. The figure is, however, lower than last year's 8%. The statistics office points to the higher annual uptick in the index of chemicals, including animal and vegetable oils and fats. The Philippine Central Bank says its shift to a variable rate format does not signify a change in monetary policy stance. According to BSP Deputy Governor Francisco Dakila Jr., the move is largely operational. The BSP announced Monday it would adopt a variable rate format with a predetermined offer volume in the auction for the overnight reverse repurchase facility. Officials said the move is part of planned operational reforms following the adoption of the interest rate corridor framework of 2016. The shift will start on September 8, Friday.
Hindi siya loosening o tightening. Wala siya sa strategy. Hindi mababago yung ating inflation targeting framework. Pagbabago lang dun sa way na ginagawa natin yung ating operations, kundi malaki ang kanyang importance doon sa efficiency ng operations at yung epekto ng ating operations doon sa market interest rates, yung link. Kaya sinasabi natin na i-enhance ito yung implementation ng monetary policy.
Now for some local corporate stories, dito CME Holdings Corporation, through its subsidiary Udeno Communication Media and Entertainment Holdings, issues 2.2 million shares to UK-based Summit Global at a consideration of 1 peso per share. The proceeds from such issuance of shares were used to fund the additional equity requirements of its operating subsidiary, Dito Telecommunity. For the Bank of the Philippine Islands, it executed its merger plans with Robinsons Bank. The merger means all assets, properties, liabilities, and obligations belonging to Robinsons Bank as of end September 2022 will be transferred to BPI. Both companies believe the move will help the two lenders advance their long-term business interests. Meanwhile, Del Monte Pacific reports a net loss of $13.1 million, down nearly 30% from last year's $30 million net loss. This is due to the high inflationary, high interest rate environment. And finally, telco giant Globe has shifted another key facility through the Energy Department's Green Energy Option Program to renewable energy. This time, the facility is in Batangas Province. Globe's network of clean energy facilities now stands at 25. Philippine beverage company Coca-Cola is pushing for sustainability in its new program. Andrea Taguinas joins us on the line for the details. Andy?
Hi, Denise. Coca-Cola Philippines has ramped up its plastic recycling drive by making use of more 100% recycled plastic materials as packaging for its products. Coca-Cola Philippines President Tony Del Rosario announced this morning that from now on, their Coca-Cola Original in 190 ml and 390 ml bottles, as well as their Wilkins Pure in 500 ml, will be made from 100% recycled PET, excluding the caps and the labels. But in order to sustain this, the beverage company also stressed the importance of the public's participation. That's why they also launched a new customer engagement program, which encourages customers to recycle their empty soda bottles by dropping them off at any of the company's 2,800 collection points across the country. These bottles will then be processed and turned into new product packaging. Del Rosario said the customers will be able to find the collection points nearest to them by scanning the QR codes printed on the labels of the Coke products they buy. This will lead them to Coca-Cola's new online sustainability hub, where they can also learn more information about recycling and how they can help. Coca-Cola hopes these initiatives will help them achieve the targets they laid out in their extended producer's responsibility program that they submitted to the Department of Environment and Natural Resources back in February. DENR Undersecretary Miguel Cuna was also present in the event, and he said that currently there are around 667 enterprises that have submitted their programs for proper management of plastic packaging waste since the EPR law took effect in August of 2022. The measure obligates plastic manufacturers to recover the plastic they generate and to package their products using materials aside from plastic. Denise?
Thanks, Andy.